5-7 Live. Now, this is very interesting. Until last week, there remained three surviving Irish veterans of the Spanish Civil War's international brigades. With the death, though, of Eugene Downing, there are now just two. Bob Doyle, who's based in London, and Cork man Michael O'Riordan. After Eugene Downing's funeral last week, our reporter Alan Tourney spoke to Michael O'Riordan about his experiences 65 years ago in Spain.
Even the olives were bleeding as the battle for Madrid thundered on.
In 1936, with fascism on the rise across Europe, Spain found its people divided and on the verge of civil war. On one side were the nationalists and fascists, supported by most of the Catholic Church, and on the other, republicans and left-wing activists. With the start of the civil war in July, each side sought international assistance. The fascists found their help from Hitler and Mussolini, and the republican appeal was answered by 40,000 foreign volunteers. Among that number were about 200 Irish men and women. Michael O'Riordan, now 85, was just 20 years of age when he took the unusual and unpopular step of leaving his Cork home and work at his father's shop to volunteer for the fight against fascism in Spain.
I was a very early reader. That was one great advantage. I still have the habit, by the way. The thing is this, I read James Connolly, and that was in learning about 1913, learning about the role of the church. Connolly's Labour, Nationality and Religion was a great education value to me. And therefore I was able to see things better and clearer than other people were. Also, my background is my people come from West Cork, from Ballingarry, which is on the Cork-Kerry border. They were native speakers. There were memories of the land war there and of the town war, you know. That was an area where Tom Barry's flying column operated. So these were all pointers to say, what side should I say? Well, geez, I couldn't say the Blue Shirt side, you see. As well as the fact that anybody, when I looked around and saw the people who supported the Blue Shirts, says, geez, I wouldn't be found dead with that mob.
Among the reasons why fascists ultimately won the Civil War was that their international support, from Hitler and Mussolini, among others, was better trained and better organised than the international brigades. But while many overseas volunteers on the Republican side were military novices who had never held a gun, the Irish volunteers had something of an advantage.
I was in the field, the Air and Vice Scouts, and in the IRA and so on, like that, I mean. And coming, as I did, from sort of West Cork, well, guns were very much part of the currency of West Cork at that time. And the Irish person did have a knowledge. We learned the warfare pretty early, pretty quickly. But then to learn something in the abstract is different when it comes to the reality. And there you are on your own. I mean, any man who goes to war and takes part in the war, he's taking part by himself, because he is actually responsible for himself and so on like that. We had very few cases of anybody really deserting, you know, because everybody was committed, you see. We weren't mercenaries, we weren't people who were just going there for a few bob or something like that. We were people who went there to help the people of Spain.
On the 1st of August in 1938, Michael was badly injured in battle on the Ebro front.
I was wounded in the shoulder, actually, and there was a trench mortar exploded right behind me. We were going up this hill, and it went off right behind me, and blew some of my shoulder off, actually, and it was badly wounded, and I was told to go back to the first aid and see what happens there, and they sent me on to the hospital, and at the hospital there was no facilities. The one thing I remember about the hospital was that the smell of the wounded men, the bandages were never changed, you know, and they were there for weeks, like, you know. And then when they took out the bandages out of me, they had no anaesthetic. They had to pluck them out of forceps, you know, and probing a wound looking for bits of meat wasn't very pleasant.
In the early stages of the Spanish Civil War, a small number of Irish Blue Shirts had travelled to Spain under the leadership of Owen O'Duffy to fight alongside the fascists with the blessings of the Catholic hierarchy in Ireland. But Irish volunteers like Michael O'Riordan fighting on the opposite side didn't come face to face in battle with their countrymen.
I never called them fascists, by the way. I never called the Irish blue shirts fascists in Spain. O'Duffy was a bloody fascist bastard. I mean, they were so on like that. But the ordinary fellas who went there, I think, believed that they were fighting for faith, for the faith. They soon learned the opposite, you know. And they sort of mutinied and they wanted to come back. And I had the viewpoint with them anyway, that they weren't fascists. They were agents. No, I did say to one, no, you weren't fascist, but I said, you were victims of a very, very clever trick to persuade you were going to fight for the faith in Spain.
Prominent in Spain's anti-fascist Popular Front movement at the time was the female communist known by the name La Pasionaria, whose rendition of the Internazionale was renowned. De la paz el hermoso estandarte. It was La Pasionaria who coined the Republican battle cry No Pasarán, an appeal to the people of Madrid to hold out against the fascist onslaught. Michael O'Riordan met La Pasionaria on a number of occasions.
Very beautiful woman, you know, I mean beautiful in the sense of not a dolled-up woman, but she seemed to epitomise and personify the Spanish women. Graceful. Very graceful and very fine, very impressive looking, you know. When she died, there was a tremendous... I went to the funeral. In fact, anybody who'd ever been in Spain during the war, you went to the funeral if you possibly could. And there were thousands of us. It was a fantastic funeral, I mean. All Madrid turned out and all the Republican flags turned out and everybody said, no pasarán, no pasarán.
No pasarán, the pledge that made him fight. Adelante is the cry around the hillside. Let us remember them tonight.
Fascinating memories. That was the International Brigade veteran Michael O'Riordan talking to our reporter Alan Torney.